Next, we're going to be creating the server. So setting up the server is very simple, but it has to be done right. It's very, very pivotal. So what we need to do is install Node.js. If you don't already have it, head over to nodejs.org, install it, and make sure that it's running. Now, once it's running, it's actually going to be running and accessible through your terminal. So it's not something that you're going to have to open up and run. So once you've done that, the next thing we're going to do is going to be installing the Heroku tool belt. So in order to do that, just head over to toolbelt.heroku.com and download and install this as well. Once you've done that, we're going to be following these instructions. It's very simple. You're going to come into your terminal. You're going to log into Heroku by following this command. It's $heroku login. And let me show you what that looks like in here. You're going to press enter. It's going to ask you for your login and your password. Once you've done that, you want to CD into your app. So you probably don't have an app folder created, so we're going to create one right now. So let me show you what that looks like. So before we can do that, we need to go over some of the command lines that you can be using right here inside of Terminal. So when you see this character right here, that means that you're in your home directory. So anytime you're curious where is home, this will signify it. So once you're in this directory, you can do certain things. So for example, let's say we did the ls command. It's going to list out all of the folders that belong to our root folder. So we see we have documents, downloads, Dropbox, pictures, and so on, right? If we want to see where we are in terms of everything else, like what folders are in front of us and behind us and that sort of thing. So we can use pwd, which is going to print the working directory. And you could see we're in smk, and in front of us it's users. So let's say that we wanted to go into one of these directories. All we have to do is put change directory, which is cd, and then the name of the directory. So let's say we did documents. I'll do copy, and we'll paste it right here, which you're more than welcome to do. And boom, we're in documents. And then you could see right here, we're in documents. So if you're ever curious where you are, just print it out, and you can see that we're in documents, and smk is the folder above us. So let's say we want to go back up to smk. How would we do that? We would do cd space dot dot, takes us right back in it, and here we are. So these are some of the very, very high level things that we can do with it. So one of the other things we can do is we can create folders. So in order to make a folder, all we have to do is do mkdir, which stands for make directory, and then we create the name of the folder. So in this case, we're going to call this Parrot app, or just call it Parrot. So parrot. And if you want to create this in your right off of your root folder, you can go ahead and do that. But in my case, I want to create it in the desktop. So how am I going to do that? I'm going to come in and I'm going to change directory, go to desktop, and boom, now I'm in desktop. And then I'm going to do make directory. Right, make directory, enter, and boom, I've made the directory. Now let's see if it's there. And it's right here. You can see I've in the list, Node.js sandbox, it's right there. So let's move into this directory. We'll do cd. And also you want to make sure that it's lowercase, so you don't want to use any uppercase. So now we know that we are here in Parrot, and just to make double sure, boom, we could see we're in desktop in Parrot, in the Parrot app. So let's say that, just to give you another example, it's right up here. So we could see the folder it was created. So once we've done that, now we can follow this. So we make sure we're in here, and let's finish up the Heroku install. We want to CD into the app, so we just did that. And then we want to do Heroku create. Okay, now I already have the tool belt, but in your case, you want to do $heroku create. You can also copy and paste it, and I will provide this stuff in all of the resources. So you can do a lot of copy and pasting. So boom, and just press enter, and boom, it'll let you go ahead and it'll create that for you. So once you've done that, the very next thing I need you to do is you want to get the latest version of npm. Now, here's the command line for that. It's sudo npm install npm global. And the way that looks is something like this. Control V. Enter. It's going to ask you for your password, so let me put mine in real quick. Once you've done it, it's going to initialize. It's going to go through all these different processes. It's going to install the npm for you and make sure that it's up to date. After we've done that, we're going to initialize Git. What does that mean? It's going to create a repository inside that folder. So, you know, we can create programs and that sort of thing. So as soon as this is done, that's going to be the next step. So once you've completed this, it's going to look something like that. So let's do npm. Boom, there you go. So now what it's going to do, it's going to walk us through creating the package. So right now, the first thing it's asking me is, what do you want to call your app? So I will call it Parrot. Then it's going to say, what's the version? And 1.0.0 is fine. Description, you could add a description here. You can make it say whatever you want. You can skip this just by pressing Enter, which is what I'm doing right now. You can add your Git repository to here. Keywords, again, this is so people could find it more easily. Author, you could put your name here. License, and then it'll say, does this look okay? You could say yes. And boom, it's created it for you. So let's do a ls just to see what's in this folder. So now we know that in the Parrot folder, we have the package.json file in there. So once you've done this, good job so far. Now, last but not least, we're going to be installing the dependencies. So this dependency is called the body-parser, and it's going to allow us to manipulate how the messages look. So it's going to parse them up. So you can do copy and paste it in here, or you can just follow along and put npm install express request body-parser, and then just enter it, and it's going to go through this process. And boom, so now you have the this dependency. It's very, very important that you have this dependency. So once you've done this, congratulations, you have set up your server and you're ready to move on to the next part. And once again, thank you for taking the class. I look forward to seeing you in the next one.